expensive, and she wasn't able to save much. She even ate soup from ketchup packets. So gross. She returned home and was finally able to serve a mission in the Philippines. She loved the work and the people there. She especially loved having a maid to pick up after her. She came home in February 1979, got a job, and enjoyed a few years of young adult life making friends. In June of 1980, she married Craig White in the Los Angeles Temple. They had three children, Melissa, born in 1981, Matthew, born in 1982, and Megan, born in 1984. Megan's childbirth, there were complications during Megan's childbirth, and she was unable to have any more children. She got divorced in 1992 and realized she needed to get a job to support her family. So she went back to school to get a degree in accounting. She worked part-time and went to school full-time. She got her AA degree from Victor Valley College and her bachelor degree from UC San Bernardino, both with honors. It was a very hard time for her, but she persevered, and with the help from family and the church, she did it. She got a job with the County of San Bernardino and worked there until she was forced to retire for health reasons. She had kidney problems and had to go on dialysis, so she sold her home and moved in with her sister Debbie, where she lived until March of 2021. She then went to live with her daughter Melissa and family. Her son Matthew and her daughter Megan both served missions. Matthew served in Georgia and North Carolina, and Megan served in Idaho. She was so proud of them, and their decision to serve brought her much joy. She was also very proud of Melissa, who got a degree as a paralegal. She has three grandchildren, Corwin, Richie, and Mackenzie, who she loved dearly. She also had many nieces and nephews who loved visiting her in her room, where she would give them candy and let them sit and push the buttons on her electric bed. In her later years, her good friends Debbie Avila and Debbie Rathbone would come by and take her places just to get her out. They would all go out and celebrate their birthdays together. She appreciated their friendship so very much. One of Margie's favorite things to do was to go to Disneyland. It truly was a magical place for her. She collected bells, loved making lemon meringue pie, and every Christmas until she got sick, she would make gingerbread houses and give them to others for Christmas. Her service in the church was mostly with adults. She taught in Relief Society and also as a gospel doctor and teacher. She loved teaching. She was very grateful for her home and visiting teachers who helped her along the way, especially Brother Judd for his counsel and kindness. To all who are here today, she would tell you she loved you and would want to thank you for your friendship.
Thank you. We'll now have a special musical presentation. Excuse me, when I'm not sure. Quite a few of these names, I'm sure. Aislinn, Espen, Andrea, Bryden, Aria, Oakland. Thank you. Okay, we'll have a talk by Nate Mouser, after which we'll, I'll just go from there. So, Marty promised that I would not have to do this. I don't remember this. I gotta be honest, I don't remember this. I kind of feel like this is great. I just want to put that out there. Shit. Okay. So, one of the things, as I was talking about, just a quick aside before I get in, she, I remember didn't like something. If it wasn't chilling, she's like, all on top of her head. Pretty dramatic. But, we're here to celebrate life and to celebrate her life. And one of the things that meant the most to her was something that we call in the church festival, it's a concept called the time of salvation. It is the thing that converted her, brought her closer to our Savior Jesus Christ. And while we are here, and death is something that we're sad. It's a separation from people that we love. In fact, the last time that I was standing at this pulpit, I was given a eulogy from my father. But mourning is one of the deepest expressions of our love. For those who don't, it's important that we remember that in this life, as we come here, this wasn't our beginning. Our birth wasn't our beginning. We were with Father God before this. And as we came here, we really gained experience. We came here to learn how to be more loving, how to be good people, how to turn our lives into something glorious and full of purpose. And we did so knowing that this was not a one-way trip. Usually, when I do that trip, I like to what I came from, to that home. We knew that the best part of the trip we were taking here to this life was that we would be able to return to live with a loving Father. Now, because he loves us, sometimes we get to do hard things. Sometimes life is tough. And Marty certainly had her times where life did its best to be there. But one of the things that helped her do that was her abiding love and testimony of Jesus Christ. It is because of his atonement and his resurrection that we have faith and hope in a better way, in a reunion with those who have gone before us. This is not a family. This is an opportunity for us. He sent our Savior Jesus Christ to do things that we could not do for ourselves, overcome. Overcome sin, separation of spiritual nature. death is a necessary component of our eternal existence. No one knows when it will come. It is essential to God's great plan of happiness. Thanks to the atonement of the Lord, eventual resurrection is a reality, and eternal life is a possibility for all of us. For those who get left behind, those sorrowing at our temporary separation from those in our life who we want to be with, the sting of death can be soothed and swallowed up in the faith. The love of God and a hope for something better. When we have that faith, when we have that hope, we have that love. Family, with my family, and during time to me, can bless our lives in many ways. I'm grateful for the example that she gave of selflessness and mercy and trying time. Was she perfect? Her sister. She wasn't perfect. None of us are perfect, right? None of us have that online. But, in the hope. That was her hope. That was her hope. And I testify that I know that it is true, and that someday we will be able to be that person. What a glorious reunion. What a glorious time to be with him. I know that he died for us, is in the wilderness, and that he lives for us now, is in the wilderness.
Before we close here, I'd just like to let you know that the family has invited anyone that's like to go to the burial and the grave dedication in San Apple. It's all the park out there right after this is over. And then there'll be a lunch back here. So we'll go ahead and close by seeing him, God be with you. 152. And then Marta Braden will give us her closing prayer.
Thank you.
We're so grateful for you. Thank you.